Hello, and welcome to this week's episode of MCTV. I'm Tiffany Strain. MCTV is your weekly news source for all things happening on the campus of Mississippi College. This week we have highlights from the Lunar Moon Festival, FitMC, Aha Gazelle, International Day of Social Justice, the BSU Missions Banquet, Main Street Minute, and we have Josh Clark with the highlights from MC Sports. Let's get to the news. The Office of Global Education hosted a Lunar New Year party in Alumni Gym where students could learn and celebrate the Asian culture.
Tonight we're having the Lunar New Year party, which is celebrated by several Asian countries. Tonight we're having students are here and people from the community are here learning about Korean letters and Korean alphabet, about the language of writing calligraphy in Chinese, and also two different games, Chinese chess and Yukmari, which is from South Korea. We're having special things tonight, like oranges, which represent good fortune. There are watermelon seeds that are also very prevalent, eaten in Taiwan and the southern part of China for their Lunar New Year celebration. And then we'll have opportunity tonight to have a yo-yo exhibition and also have some singing in Chinese, and just lots of fun celebrating for them, for Chinese students, and for South Korean students and Vietnamese. This is their Christmas and their Thanksgiving, all wrapped up into one thing.
This week, FitMC, Dr. Susanna McDonough talks about the ways exercise can prevent cancer.
Hi, Susanna McDonough again. Last week I talked a little bit about how much exercise you need to do to, you know, have the most health benefits. 30 minutes a day is probably your best bet. Why should you do it? We know that for cardiovascular disease, metabolic conditions, and cancer prevention, we talk about it, but we don't really know how much benefit it has. The latest research says that cancer can be really affected by how much you exercise, because it stimulates the immune system. Most of you have probably heard about chemotherapy, surgery, radiation as being the most common ways to treat cancer. And now we hear about immunotherapy, gene therapy, and you know, you think, what does that mean? So if you exercise, your body turns on the immune system to do all the repair work and you know, fix things that are broken down. And so if a cancer tumor has started growing somewhere in your body, they really do think that exercise, because you know, it stimulates the immune system, it can prevent a lot of this potential tumor development. Latest research just says that, and these are longitudinal studies that have, you know, just have really caught my eye. I am the only cancer exercise trainer in the state of Mississippi. I have my certification and license from Rocky Mountain Institute in Colorado, and I have the American College of Sports Medicine exercise training certification. And it's not wildly popular right now for doctors to prescribe exercise, but I'm hoping they will in the future.
Christian Development hosted a Christian rap concert in the Bowl last week. Recording artist Aha Gazelle performed as part of the Racial Reconciliation Series at Mississippi College.
Hey everybody, for the first time ever in history, Christian Development is hosting the first ever Christian rap concert. We got Aha Gazelle here. He's a Reach recording artist from Atlanta. He lives in Baton Rouge, and he's here live, and we're so excited.
Hey, I'm Christian Way. I'm here at The Conversation Live. This is a concert where we're here to promote nothing but racial reconciliation and show people how it only comes through and is only possible through the gospel. And we're excited to see different things and experience different cultures.
The Social Justice Club celebrated the International Day of Social Justice with a table set up in the CAF.
I'm Alexis Rogers. I'm the president of the Social Justice Club here on MC's campus. And so what we do is that we have three pillars that we stand for. We volunteer, educate, and donate. And so we're a club that wants to create sustainable, positive change in the world around us. And so we do that through discussion and educating people, such as today for International Day of Social Justice, February 20th. We're out here inside the CAF talking to people, giving candy for questions so we can answer things like, what is social justice? What is Social Justice Club? But we also volunteer in the communities of Clinton and Jackson, such as we do 4Cs here in Clinton, and we also do Mississippi Animal Rescue League in Jackson, and we also do Stew Pot in Jackson as well. And then we donate to places like our local charity, which is Stew Pot, and then our international charity, which is We Feed the Children, which helps create sustainable change in third world countries.
The Social Justice Club meets every Thursday at 6:30 p.m. in Jennings 308. The BSU Missions Banquet was on Thursday night in Anderson Hall, Family and friends gathered together for a night of prayer and encouragement for the 23 missionary students from MC who will be traveling around the world this summer. Kate Winston met up with the ladies of Main Street Clinton to learn about upcoming events this spring in our new segment, Main Street Minute.
Hello, I'm Tara Lytle, the director of Main Street Clinton.
I'm Anna Hawks, the assistant director of Main Street.
And we want to tell you about some fun events that we've got coming up this spring that we hope that you might be able to attend. We have a tea time shopping spree with a Mad Hatter Tea Party coming up the end of March. March the 22nd and through the 24th, we'll have shopping downtown and a scavenger hunt, culminating with this Mad Hatter Tea Party on the brick streets. Fun time for everybody.
Back this year, we have the Spring into Green Market and the 11th Annual Caterpillar Parade. This is a really popular event in our community. We'll have vendors lining in Jefferson Street, and we'll have a parade through Old Town. So come check that out. April 14th, the parade starts at 10 a.m. And then in April, every Friday night, we have something going on downtown. We've got dinner and a movie, dinner and jazz, and then Taste the Town, a new local restaurant night.
Be sure to follow them on the Instagram and Twitter pages to find out more. Now we turn to Josh Clark for the latest in MC sports. Josh?
Thanks, Tiffany. It was another jam-packed and exciting week in the Choctaw sporting world, so let's dive right in. After a long season filled with plenty of exciting moments and building hope for the future, the men's and women's basketball teams finished up their regular season play this past week. The Choctaws were in Huntsville, Alabama last weekend to take on UAH for the second and final time this year. The women started the series off but could not close a two-point gap late in the fourth quarter and fell 71-63. The men's team tipped off soon after against the Chargers and fell to UAH 87-74. Both teams then traveled to Cleveland, Mississippi on Thursday night to close out their respective 2017-18 regular seasons against rival Delta State. The women's team fell in a hard-fought 67-53 final, while the men could not come up with an extra effort in overtime as they fell to the Statesmen 79-69. And while neither team made the tournament this season, there are reasons to believe that plenty of promise lies ahead for both Choctaw basketball programs. In other MC sporting news, the Choctaw baseball team just keeps on rolling. MC swept a three-game series against McKendree University last weekend, including a 21-1 routing of the Bearcats in the final game. The Choctaws followed this hot streak up with an 11-8 win over Arkansas Monticello that saw MC score 5 runs in the 9th inning to claim the victory. Billy Cameron knocked in 2 home runs this past week, and 4 Choctaws are currently hitting over 400 as MC is now riding a 7-game win streak and holding on to an 8-1 record overall. They'll open Gulf South Conference play this weekend with a tough matchup on the road against number 9 West Georgia. Meanwhile, the Lady Choctaws went 1-2 on the softball diamond at the GSC Opening Weekend Festival last weekend. After dropping the first 2 contests of the festival to Auburn Montgomery and Valdosta State, the Lady Choctaws picked up a big 5-3 win against Montevallo behind the hot bat of Kristen Qualls, who hit a whopping 2 home runs back-to-back over the left field wall late in the game. The Lady Choctaws are 4-5 on the season and 1-2 in Gulf South Conference play. Out on the tennis courts, both MC tennis teams are riding hot streaks as well. The men's team beat Alcorn State 7-2 on Tuesday and improved to 4-1 on the season, while the women's team won their first game of the Wachita Baptist Invitational yesterday against Wachita Baptist. They are an undefeated 4-0 on the season and have 3 more matches in the Invitational before returning home to take on West Alabama next week. And finally, the Mississippi College table tennis team defeated Mississippi State this past week. With the win, the Choctaws advance to the South Regionals at Texas Wesleyan University. That's all that's happened and is happening in the Choctaw sporting world right now. Back to you, Tiffany.
Thanks, Josh. That's all we have for this week. If you have story ideas, be sure to email them to MissCollegeTV@gmail.com and be sure to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at MissCollegeTV. You can also find us on Facebook at Facebook.com/MissCollegeTV. Thanks for watching. I'm Tiffany Strain, and we'll see you next week.